Welcome, welcome. I just wanted to go over the new UI interface changes in the newest patch that was effective this morning. So as you can see, where I'm playing Wings of Liberty, but the interface, if you guys were playing Heart of the Swarm beta, you would recognize. For example, you have this navigation over here with all the chat channels, and also the news and community banner, and then the little ticker looking thing over here. What's cool is you get a couple of options when you're playing. Some really beginner-friendly options. Beginner to, of course, the multiplayer experience. Over here on the left, you have training. You can select the different stages of your race. Each stage would make it a little bit faster. You have unlocked more units so that you can build. Versus AI is something that you're probably familiar with, more or less. And then, of course, but in the difference is when you select a different AI. Well, first you select the mode. For example, I want to only play versus only one human player versus the AI, and then you select the race. But what happens here is like it actually does a matchmaking. Not a matchmaking, but a placement kind of thing. You play a couple of times, and then it actually matches up the appropriate AI level for you. Kind of like matchmaking, except you're playing against AI. It places you in the appropriate level. Unranked is actually new to the Wings of Liberty Battle.net. What would happen is this is kind of a separate, you actually are assigned a separate MMR, which is your hidden matchmaking, multiplayer matchmaking score. What would happen is a lot of people would have anxiety. Blizzard has gotten a lot of feedback on this. So what they had to create is, okay, well, you don't want to affect your ladder rating, we understand, so we're going to make it so that you can actually still use our matchmaking system. You will still be matched up with other players with a similar MMR, but we're going to go ahead and not, we're not going to allow, I will allow that to not affect your ladder rating so that you can keep playing and you can actually keep having fun playing with other players, human players, but not have to worry about affecting your ladder rating. But of course, this is ranked as your regular ladder system that you are actually familiar with all along in Wings of Liberty and whatnot. Some other user interface changes as in-game. I won't go over that too much, but we'll see it briefly when we review the replay function. What's also added is this clan feature. I don't remember how to exactly access it. But you can create your own clans and groups. The difference is clans tend to be more formal. It could be a clan of your friends, but you can actually make up your own clan, and then you can have members, you can have leaders, you can post messages, and you can meet in a common meeting room or channel. Groups are more informal. They're grouped by, for example, over here, they're grouped by interests. Let's go ahead and look at some replay features that that have come with this new patch. For example, before you're only able to watch solo, but by yourself. But now you're actually able to invite other people to watch a replay with you. So how this works is one person, who is the leader of the replay, will control how fast it goes, the speed of the replay, if you're and at which point in the replay you're going to jump to. And then when you're ready, you can actually, basically when you select watch with others, it will put you in this lobby looking thing right here, in which you can actually invite your friends if they're online. And then once everyone's in here, looks like it fits quite a number of people, maybe 16 people in total, then all you have to do is just click on watch. And then, as you can see, the splash screen right here is much bigger than it used to be. This map right here used to be really small, and it's hard to actually clearly see the different features, like starting points and expansions. So this interface is very similar, the computer, I mean the observer interface and the replay interface. The only difference is, for example, there's a couple of more options over here, like active forces. You can actually see all the structures that they currently have built. And then remember, because sometimes, you know, when you're observing, you're actually you're trying to look for a building, or you're wondering if they have a building. For example, I wanna find the hatchery on this map. Or more importantly, I see that the Zerg player has an overlord, so I'm gonna click on this right here on this UI element, and you can see it jumps right to the overlord. But what's cool about this replay feature is actually at any point in the game, in which, of course, the game has to be a new game, a game that you've played with this new patch. You can actually stop at any point in the game, and then select this take command feature, and then if you have multiple plays right here, you can actually say, okay, for this red Zerg player, I want to replace him with, and then this with this drop down box. You select the player that you want to replace him, and then you can go ahead and resume the game as if you're playing from the very beginning. But what, of course, is a disadvantage of this is you actually inherit all of their hotkeys. So if you're playing, playing from your own replay, you'll have to rebind all these hotkeys because you're using that person's hotkeys. So if you don't, for example, if you want to resume from a replay, excuse me, and if you don't want to actually go through and watch the replay, for example, if you're playing in an online tournament or you're playing with friends and you get disconnected, what you want to do is you want to resume from the last point in the game. So you want to actually, it's not here, you have to actually pick one of a new replay, right click and click on recover game, and then what it will that will do will it'll bring you into a replay looking lobby, and then here you can invite people, I believe, and then you select recover game, and then this little dialog pops up. You can see that it tells you a little different points in the game where the replay shows some kind of activity. For example, somebody paused the game, the game ended. This is kind of weird. Maybe there's sometimes it detects a disconnect. But what's cool is actually you actually resume. For example, you want to resume 1 minute, 18 seconds into the game, and you click start, and then there's a countdown, just like if you're starting a regular game or if you're starting a replay. But what's cool is it will resume at that point in the game without having you or making you watch the replay. Especially when you're in a tournament setting, you don't want to be watching from a replay anyways, because you can actually look at your opponent's view and see exactly where all their units and their buildings are. Okay, so this splash screen right here will show you that this recovering bar, when it reaches full, you get this countdown. And then after that, it's just like the resume from replay option. And then voila, now you're back in the game as if nothing ever happened. And this is really useful if you get disconnected a lot, or a lot of people from tournaments, they complain about disconnecting and having to regame something. And then there's other changes for the UI. I don't know if you noticed, but when you clicked on the hatchery or any of your Nexus or your control center, your command center, you'll see the number of workers that are currently in mining. That's useful. And in addition to that, you also get the same for your gas geysers. So hopefully you enjoyed this replay and this review of the new user interface changes, and hope to see you soon.